I'm John Dory, knocking you out here on Boxing Tribune. BoxingTribune.com welcomes the Irish sensation himself, John Duddy. You're fighting Anthony Bonsante on the eve of St. Paddy's Day Parade. How do you feel about Bonsante?
I think that's a great step for me after the Yuri Boy Campos fight. You know, I've seen Anthony on the contender like everybody else, and to be honest, you have a lot of respect for the man in the ring and out of the ring. You know, I think he brings a true meaning for a hungry fighter. You know, he's got two kids, and he does a night shift, and he came there for the press conference there yesterday, and he had to go home because he was working at 10 o'clock again. And I mean, like, that man's coming to win. He's not coming to make up numbers, and he's got a great chin. He's got 17 knockouts, nearly as many fights as me, and I'm really looking forward to it. I'm going to be up for it and hopefully put on a great show for all the fans of New York and the Madison Square Garden on the 16th.
He's got a well-rounded professional pedigree considering his contender status.
Yeah.
You could punch, you could box. You said to yourself you had a tough time against in your previous fight. Do you think Bonsante's going to put any funds for you?
Oh, definitely. I'm sure he's going to ask me some questions that maybe Yuri Boy didn't, you know. He proved against whenever, right, Joe? He proved against Matt Vanda that he can figure out styles and adapt to try and fight somebody at what their assets are. And he gave Vanda a boxing lesson whenever they fought up in Minnesota. But you know what I mean? He's a clean-cut guy, he's a well-spoken guy, and I know exactly that he's going to come to that fight they won, and he's everybody there is going to be against him. And I think a man of his pedigree, that's only going to make him want it even more. So I'll be not doubting Anthony Bonsante one bit at all. I think physically and mentally more prepared than I was going on against Yuri Boy Campos, and I think it's going to be a smashing fight.
Now, I know everybody's been asking you this, but have the cuts completely healed?
So far, so good. Hopefully, if you can see them there, you know, I suppose I have the scars forever, but if I was worried about my looks, I wouldn't be a boxer. But I think I never had a cut problem before, and the doctor, the specialist, says that the more time you have healing, the better. And I've had plenty of time. I'm fed up sitting on my ass. I had a good Christmas, and I'm just looking forward to getting back into the ring and doing my trade again.
The eve of St. Paddy's Day, it's got to be a little crazy for you, right?
Well, I suppose I'm going to try my best to make it crazy for everyone else. I'm looking forward to it. This is my third time headlining the show again. And I think, well, last Paddy's Day, we sold it out. And I think this year we're going to sell it out even more. And it's also available on pay-per-view. So it is on demand on your local cable subscribers. And I think the numbers that's going to come to this fight is going to be tremendous. And hopefully I'm going to get St. Patrick's Day off to a good start again.
Now, do you think that pay-per-view, is there any more pressure on your shoulders? You're headlining.
I don't know. Headlining, you know what I mean? If I was to be worried about the cameras, well, then I shouldn't be in the ring. This is all part and parcel, and I think that the team that I have, you know, we're taking the right steps forward. We're not jumping in too deep, and we're taking it baby steps at a time, a fight at a time, and it's proven fruitful for us so far, and I can't see that changing anytime soon. And you know what I mean? As long as I keep winning, hopefully we'll just keep this, rolling and keep the fans coming and keep them excited.
You're leading basically a pack of very stellar, very popular Irish fighters. You're basically at the head of the pack. Do you feel a little bit better about yourself that you kind of put Irish boxing on the map once again?
I don't know. I don't think so. I think, you know what I mean, the crop of Irish fighters all speaks for themselves, and what makes us stand out even more is the fact that we've got great fans, and they'll come out and support us no matter where we're fighting or where we're traveling. And I'm very fortunate from there, and along with the success, the numbers seems to be growing and growing, and not just in Irish fans, all fans. Like, I think New York's taking me under a wing. Like, you've got all the Latinos and African Americans coming out to support me, you know what I mean, from the Bronx, from Brooklyn, Queens, Manhattan, Staten Island, and I'm loving it, and I'm going to work damn hard to make sure that they're happy and keep coming to the fights.
Between me, you, and the fans, you got to be happy that the fight isn't happening on St. Paddy's Day, don't you?
Well, at least it gives me time to enjoy a drink after the show.
That's what I wanted to see. Thank you very much, John Duddy.
Thanks very much, man.